hot one today.
Put the cookies on the bench. Just dump it on the bench nicely.
We are going to run some errands, buy our food for our animals because they eat a lot, and then we're going to see Warcraft. We are. And I'm kind of excited to see it. I mean, I think Warcraft looks really good. I asked some of my Overwatch buddies who have some of my Overwatch buddies have never quit playing World of Warcraft. Now, some of them stopped playing. They just got tired of the game. A lot of garbage, I guess, in the game. And they stopped playing. But some of them still play, and I asked, anyway, the point is, I asked some of my Overwatch buddies if they were going to see Warcraft, and they're like, yeah, probably not. They just didn't seem interested in seeing. I think it looks incredible from the trailer, previews and things. I thought Warcraft looked amazing. Special effects wise and everything. I don't know. We'll see if it's a good flick. I'm not one of these people who really go watch a movie and then just rip it apart. You know, I usually give every movie kind of the benefit of the doubt and just kind of, you know, appreciate the really good things in the movie, and if there was some bad things, whatever. But some people, they see a movie and there were some bad spots, they just tear the whole movie apart just because of a few bad scenes or whatever. But I'm not one of those guys. I usually kind of give the movie the benefit of the doubt. And this one looks really good simply because of the CGI in it. The orcs and the things like that look incredible. So I'm looking forward to it. So we're going to see that. What time is it?
9:35.
Okay, so the movie starts...
12:30.
So we got plenty of time to get our errands ran and then go see the movie. I'm looking forward to it. And it's Friday. And it's the beginning of the weekend vlog.
Busy weekend.
And it's going to be a very busy weekend because, well, today we're seeing the movie and getting all the, you know, the responsible. Watching a movie isn't responsible, but getting all the other responsible stuff out of the way. Then going seeing a movie, and then we're going to my dad's to pick up a lawnmower and just to hang out with him because we're not going to be there next weekend for Father's Day. And then Sunday is my daughter's graduation party. And then next week, my wife is gone for 4 days. Not happy about it. But here's the cool thing. Sort of the cool thing. I'm still a little torn between because of this decision. I guess it's just weird to me. I'm taking the whole summer off. I'm just gonna just hang out with this kid and her all summer long.
And you're torn by that?
Just because it's just, you know, because I work every day. So then, like, not working every day is just, it's kind of different. It's kind of weird.
I'd be loving it.
I mean, I'm not saying it's not going to be great.
Take the summer off.
I'm like a school teacher. I'm not a school teacher, but that's what it feels like. Like, I get the summers off. Alrighty. Got to fuel the vehicle up. And then we're just going to go see a movie and buy dog food and boring stuff like that. The movie's not going to be boring, but the other stuff's boring. So, and getting gas isn't very exciting. So I'll see you guys in the next clip. Thank you. We got some Sonics, burgers and fries, whatever. You know, it's whatever.
Yeah.
Gonna enjoy our very unhealthy food. We're gonna enjoy some good grease. Every once in a while, you gotta have some good grease. It helps your poops come out better.
That's gross.
It's disgusting. And then we're going to see the movie, so gonna get into this bag of deliciousness.
And you don't have an occasional floating around that you forgot about. So if you go to look and you see that, okay, there's two other people.
So lunch was good, greasy, and terrible for us. Great lunch. Now we're heading to the theater to see Warcraft IMAX. It's going to be good. I know it's going to be good. It's too good. And I've been saying for years, when I used to play World of Warcraft, I said all the time, because I used to always watch the cinematics at the beginning of the game. It's like they really need to make a movie. They listen to me. They're making a movie. And we're going to see it. And it's going to be awesome. At least, you know, it should be. I'll let you know.
It'd be good.
What are you doing back there?
Texting.
Now it's like 22 minutes of
research on of perfect cards and smash it into a tree.
Advertisements and future movies. And I look good in these glasses, don't I? It's a good look for me. They're really big, dark glasses.
Just one of the many features that come standard with our base policy.
All right. We are one happening family. Yep. About 20 minutes of waiting for Warcraft, and then the movie starts. We got popcorn. We got drink. We got cool shades. And we got a big screen. Screen's massive. It's huge. It's awesome. The seats are comfortable. Love this theater. Seats are like super comfy. Do you think?
Yeah, it's a good theater.
Daddy.
Very good theater.
Shut the camera off. I need to get a picture.
Okay, gotta go. Probably gonna get like copyright strike on something, maybe.
Ooh, it's toasty up here. 45 minutes.
So my opinion on Warcraft was it was awesome. What was your opinion?
Seriously? She's not coming to the movies anymore.
You didn't like it?
No.
She didn't think she was gonna like it. I thought it was amazing. I thought it was awesome. It's such a good movie. If you're a fan of World of Warcraft, the game, you're gonna love this movie. Well, even if you're not a fan of World of Warcraft, you probably would become a fan of World of Warcraft after watching this. I loved it. I thought it was awesome. I thought it was great. What do you think?
Oh, good. Very good.
I was mad.
It was just, if you're a fan of World of Warcraft and the game, you're going to love this movie simply because there's so much from the game in the movie. Well, probably just from the whole storyline. Like, it is.
But even if you don't follow the storyline, it still looks amazing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, special effects-wise. Incredible. I liked it a lot. I'll tell you this, not giving away any spoilers, it gives me a whole new perspective on the orcs.
Yeah.
And, you know, and the whole horror bit. It's good. If you haven't seen it, go see it. You'll love it. Whether you like World of Warcraft or not, you're going to love this movie simply for the special effects and all the CGI. An amazing, amazing, amazing movie. It looked incredible. Good flick. Check out Warcraft. Amazing movie. You're going to love it, I promise. I promise you'll love it. She didn't love it, but, you know, she don't appreciate anything unless it's made by Disney.
Yeah.
She was a good dog. She had some anxiety about us just leaving her inside because we never do, but it's too hot to put her outside while we're gone, so we just left her in, but... I mean, she did good. She just freaking out a little bit. Probably because we was gone so long, seeing the movie and doing other things. So she did well. Anyway, I'm going to end the vlog right here for today. We got stuff to do, stuff to take care of. Going to end the vlog for today. I'll see you guys in the morning when we're heading 3 hours south to see my father. And I'm much looking forward to that. Probably not going to get no drone footage. Maybe. We'll have to see. It's just a busy weekend because of today and then going to see my dad tomorrow. It's going to take all day because, you know, it's a three-hour drive there. Spend some time with him. Three-hour drive back. We're not going to go back till later. And then Sunday we have a graduation party for my daughter that we're putting on at the local park. So maybe I'll get some drone footage there of all that going down. We'll see. But I got the whole summer. I got the whole summer of drone footage and all sorts of stuff going on. So anyway, I will see you guys in the morning. You want a cookie? You want a cookie? Sit. Sit. You want a cookie? You want a cookie? You want a cookie?
That's
to the
nuts.
Try it. Taste it. Taste it. Taste it. Just taste it. Ow! Okay, you don't have to taste it. They do look good, though. Chunky.
Is it breakfast time? Good morning, sir. Are you hungry?
He is the cutest dog ever. I mean, he's adorable. It is Saturday morning, and we are heading off to my... It's early Saturday morning. See, here's the thing about my wife and myself. When we take a small trip or... even a larger trip. Say we went to Oklahoma one time for a race, which is like 17 hours from us. We get up early morning, we get in the vehicle, and we go. And we've always done that. So we're up early to go see my dad. It's like a two and a half, 3 hour drive. And it's like 4:30 in the morning, but I'm usually up around that anyway.
doesn't faze me too much, but Emily is thinking, what the heck? It's summertime, why am I up at 4:30 in the morning? Anyway, we're gonna hop in my daughter's truck, which we had to borrow my daughter's truck because I'm a worthless country boy and don't have a truck. I mean, really, every man in this town has a truck. I have a green golf cart. I'm not a country boy. I don't belong in this small town. Anyway, so we're gonna hop in my daughter's truck and we're gonna go see my dad.
Came with oh, my baby boy.
Doing good.
Oh, I haven't seen you forever.
Oh. Hi, Shorty.
I'm released right now. I'm on the bottom of the hill.
I know. You and Becky's about the same height.
Hey, you got hurt.
What are you even scared of her for, you weirdo?
I feel bad for y'all.
Hi, Chubby.
What the fuck?
Hi, dear.
He's shedding. He's shedding so bad.
There it
boy.
Is.
He's shedding so bad, boy.
Yeah, that'd fit with that topper.
He's even got a cover for us, in case you have to leave it outside.
Nice. I need a mower so bad, you don't even know. Ice Easter.
Time of the week, or text him as well, 664.
He covers everything.
It's my Easter. Hi, Easter. How you doing?
Yard sale.
I got you a baby version of what I have. It's a nano drone.
Call this person at 335.
You want me to wreck that thing? How do you drive it?
It's got a controller.
It's got a remote controller.
It's got a controller. And
your dad's got a baby drone.
Okay. The drone's rechargeable, but the controller requires batteries.
He's got a baby drone.
That's cute.
And he flies inside.
Yeah, but what if it gets away from me?
I don't have a camera on it. It's like it's just a little baby.
You can sit out here and fly.
You can fly it inside too. Mine's programmed with a database of places that I absolutely can't fly, so it won't let you go on.
What's it got
to? It's to charge.
Oh, through a computer?
Yeah, or whatever.
Got a request here that they're asking $60 for that, and the phone number for that was 604-8645. That's 604-8645 for a screened in gazebo. $60 are asking for that. Also, let's see, we've got 3 13-inch new tires. They're asking $20 each or four for 3 13-inch new tires, $20. Any musicians out there? Great item right here. Great brand too. Fender electric guitar and amplifier. Like new, with case and all accessories. If you're a beginner or a collector. We also have a light oak table lamp. Excellent condition. Light oak table lamp. Excellent condition. $55. You can call 618-664-9318. That's 664-9318.
I need to get back and try this. Can you help me out with this one?
This is gold.
It's rose pattern gold, full set of china.
Okay. Thank you.
What'd you run into my thumb for?
caller was looking for a full-size wooden bed for pattern, and it's service for four, $125. Those are some great items. And you can get those items from that person. And also, they're looking for that wooden bed frame. Please call on this 217-272-4. They've got some planting to do.
There you
can
go.
Call 618-664-1684. That's 618-664-1684 with some yarn help. And we've got one item left. On the smoke shop for sale, a small Frigidaire deep freeze, 27-inch wide, 34 inches deep. It's a nice item. $70 they're asking for that. 593-6048.
That's 593-6048. He's right by the tire. Is it lined up? Oh, so close.
No.
Now I have to drop that and then put it back on. It'll go back on.
Yeah, we'll just have to do it.
Either that or just drop. Just loosen this end, maybe tip it up. Just, yeah. You need a wrench and get that.
Bradford National Bank text line looking for a repeat of a number for the gas pump from earlier. And if you're out there still listening, I'm going to text it to you in a moment. But right now, we're at Bradford Swap Shop this morning on WGEL. Thanks for being here once again. Stay tuned for more.
Hey, YouTube. Well, let me turn the light on. Alrighty, back from Dad's. The trip to Dad's was fun. It's just, it's always nice hanging out with Dad, going to see Dad. He's just so much fun. He's such a blast. I bought him a nano drone before, let me get this lens clean. I bought him a nano drone before we got there. We literally stopped in at Walmart at like 5 o'clock this morning, and I bought him a nano drone. And we had so much fun with that. We had a blast with that nano drone. Dang, my battery's going dead already. So I got to speed this up. Anyway, the trip was great. I got my birthday present home, which was a riding mower from my dad, which I'm ecstatic to have because I've been push mowing this yard for the last 10 years that I've lived here. And I used it. I will show you a clip of me using it right now. And that thing mows fantastic. I have never mowed my yard so fast ever in the last 10 years. 42-inch cut. I zipped through this yard. Fantastic. I love the mower. Then he also threw in a chainsaw, gas cans. I mean, he's just... once he starts giving, he can't stop giving. And he's a very giving person. But we had so much fun down there just hanging out with him. And we cooked some food and we just hung out. And we had a great time. And it was a blast. Always loads of fun hanging out with Dad. And now we're back. The wife is off doing a little food shopping. I had to get a shower after mowing. And I'll see you guys in the morning.
graduation party for my daughter tomorrow. I'm not sure how much vlogging is going to happen tomorrow. And then I got the whole summer off. It's vlogs every day, all day, every day. And it's going to make the best of these summer vlogs and make them fun. But anyway, guys, thank you for watching today, and I'll see you in the morning. Good morning, YouTube. I had to shut that air off. Today, it's like 77 degrees. 9 o'clock in the morning, 77 degrees. Yesterday, it was blazing hot out, so I had the air kicked way up to keep it cool in here. I walk in here this morning, and it's freezing here. So, I mean, Illinois weather. Almost 100 degrees yesterday. 30 degrees less today. It's crazy around here. It's crazy around here. Anyway, I'm getting the drone ready to go out and get some shots. Gonna head uptown and try to do some flyovers and stuff. I don't know. I'm just gonna try to get some shots just for the vlog. So getting ready to go do that. Gonna hop on the Green Machine, our fantastic, awesome golf cart. I'm gonna hop on that. And yesterday, well, I already said this, I think yesterday when I was ending the vlog, but I'll tell you this: to have a riding mower when you've been push mowing a yard for 10 years is a blessing. I mean, I don't have a very big yard, but it still makes it so nice. And it mows so much nicer than my crappy little push mower. So I feel very blessed to have it. Shout out to my dad for giving me a riding mower. Very good birthday gift. Thank you so much. And he gave me like a chainsaw because I told him I had a limb on a tree. So that's my dad. So I know I thanked him yesterday when I was signing off yesterday, but I'm thanking him again. Shout out to you, Dad, for the awesome gifts. You're cool. Very cool. Best dad in the world. I'm not even kidding. So yeah, gonna get these drone shots. Go fly the drone. It's a little windy today, like 13 mile an hour winds, according to my weather app. Let's see, 11 mile an hour, not bad. I can fly in that. I don't plan on doing a lot of real high flying. I mean, you know, as tall as some of the buildings and stuff, I guess, but just to get some drone footage for the vlog. So I'm gonna head out and do that and stop rambling and grab this Typhoon G. Loving this drone. I mean, I do have my eye on other drones simply just because this is becoming a real hobby for me. And I like options of other drones that some drones have. I really do like the Phantom 4, a lot of those options. Now, I've been hearing that the obstacle sensors are kind of, you can't rely on those in the Phantom 4. Just some reviews I've watched, you really can't guarantee that those obstacle sensors are going to stop your drone from crashing into something. Now, the idea is fantastic. The idea of having obstacle sensors to keep your drone from running into something, that's a great idea. It just needs to be worked on. It needs to be advanced. And I'm sure this is going to show up in many other drones, as did the Follow Me option and all this other stuff that is showing up in all these other drones. But I've got my eye on a few different ones. Hexo Plus I'm looking at. The Lilycam, naturally. I've been talking about that for a long time. I really want to get my hands on one of those. And there's a few other drones that I'm looking to get some, maybe some bigger ones, maybe some, so there's some drones that will hold like a camera that I'm like an SLR camera that I'm recording on right now. There's drones that will hold cameras this big. That's impressive. There's drones that will hold big movie style cameras. The drone world is ridiculous, and the technology is awesome. I mean, you're talking drones that will hold big cameras. You're talking a camera like this SLR, probably you're looking at $3,000-$4,000. And then there's drones that hold even bigger cameras. You're looking at $15,000 to $20,000, maybe even more, $1,000. That's, you're a filmmaker if you're buying drones like that. I mean, I'm a I guess in a sense, a filmmaker, just at a very little scale. And I'm cool with that. I'm cool with that. Anyway, stop rambling, Steve, and heck out there and do some drone flying. I will see you guys, well, you will see the drone footage in the next clip. Street is not going to work. It's like a wind tunnel. So you get all this wind going in between all these buildings, and it just tosses this helicopter all over. So I need a more open space, I guess. I'm not going to take my chances on crashing. So I'm going to find an open spot and fly that. Or probably the park or something. I don't know. We'll see. Party.
She graduated 2 weeks ago. We planned the party for today. It was the only time it would actually work out for everybody to show up. So there's a load of people coming, and we're getting ready to head out. Everything's loaded up. Got the family getting ready to go and do this graduation party for her, which she so much earned. Graduating, in my opinion, is a big accomplishment. So we're heading out. Shutting the house down, heading out. Well, the door's locked, so we just pull it close.
Okay. Got it on. Yeah, he got it.
Got that on camera. So if he shows up with a black eye someday, we know what happened.
Hi. How you doing? Hey, Dad.
Do it again.
Hi, Dad. Hi. Party!
Oh, sweet.
Look. I might get a picture.
It would be terrible if someone just stole it.
Why does mine only have one hat?
Exploring the library. It is hot up here.
You don't just spin a random wheel, Jada.
It wasn't attached.
Careful, watch the floors.
We already looked in there, but we didn't go in. It's just another room.
No, I'm the last one.
Alright, what's in here?
Alright, careful, Dad, don't just walk in.
Oh, God.
It'd be creepier if it was. Walk in.
Okay, I need a flashlight. Here we go.
God, Dad would just die.
Oh, my flashlight's still on.
Yes.
This is a huge room.
Watch the floor, there's powdery stuff on the floor.
It's asbestos, no big deal.
Stand on the wood.
Really?
Don't step over
this is how people die in movies. We explore the dark places.
What if
something
just ran out?
Make sure you don't step off the wood, Dad.
I think we all just nodded.
Yeah, here, I'm coming through here.
It's really hot in here.
Oh, what,
Danielle? I'm sweating.
Oh, God. These boards are... It goes to a door. There's another door.
There's another door!
Hey, that light just came on.
Oh, God.
Dad, back up.
What light came on?
Out here.
What?
Dad, open the door!
It goes to outside.
I wanna see!
It goes outside. I don't think you can open it.
Why would there be boards leading to
it? It's so dark in here.
Oh, you can't open
that door.
If you guys get this video, give it to my family.
You can't
it don't open.
You hear that coon?
Shut up. I'm going back. It's hot.
No, it opens. You gotta pull it.
Don't run. You'll fall. Whoa, system. Don't blind me.
Whoa, what the hell? Don't leave me. That door will slam shut when you guys get out.
There's not a door.
Oh, yeah.
All right. That was a very uneventful.
Until right now. Sucks yeah. Me in.
All of a sudden, a portal opens and eats my son. That wasn't so scary. This window is insane.
Yeah, I know.
Look at this. I got a
heck up here, though.
Look at this window.
It's got a little hole in it.
This window is freaking crazy. The door won't open. What's that thing?
Don't turn it.
So. All right. All right. So this is kind of cool. I mean, it's not so bad. So we're gonna. Are we? So it's probably your mom. She's not letting us out. The door won't open. What is this? Some sort of torture device.
There's an elevator key somewhere. Well, there's an elevator somewhere.
Yeah, there's an elevator in the room we're in.
So the door won't open?
I mean,
Mother!
Oh my
She's
God.
Definitely holding it.
I'm freaking hot.
Here, I'm getting this door open.
That wasn't.
Of course, I'm the last one.
That wasn't so scary. It was blazing hot up there. Bunch of wimps. They're all scared.
No. What was up there?
That concludes this weekend's weekend vlog. And it was a busy weekend. Friday going to see the movie, Saturday traveling for a total of nearly 7 hours to visit my dad, a round trip, 7 hours. And then my daughter's graduation party and my niece's graduation party kind of combined into one. They're the exact same age, naturally, and they graduated at the exact same time. And it was cool to get together with a bunch of people we knew and a bunch of friends and family and have a graduation party for them. They so deserved to have this little get together and this little party and the gifts and the things, because graduation is kind of a big deal. It's a very big deal it's a huge accomplishment to graduate high school. It's a very, very big deal in my opinion. I've said this before, you don't necessarily have to have a high school diploma to be successful. I know loads of people who are successful without one, but in my honest opinion is, why not? Why not just graduate high school and get that diploma? It's, for one, it's a huge accomplishment, and for two, it shows that, you know, you're determined and you know, you try hard for something, because getting through high school isn't easy. I mean, it's definitely not easy. So sometimes it's someone's best years of their life being in high school, and for others, not so much. For others, it's more of a challenge, and it's just more difficult. And you know, sometimes high school just isn't easy for someone. That wasn't the case for my daughter or my niece. I think they had a good high school experience, but they graduated, and that's a great accomplishment, and very proud of them. Super proud of them. And that's the weekend vlog, guys. I haven't looked at none of the footage, and a lot of times when I'm doing these weekend vlogs, I forget what I even recorded, or sometimes I forget to record, especially this weekend because it was so busy. So if this weekend vlog is a little weird or a little off or a little different, I apologize, because there was just so much going on that sometimes vlogging just completely slipped my mind, especially at my dad's, and for this graduation, I didn't even really think too much about it. But anyway, that is the weekend vlog, and it's going to be kind of a sad week for me this week. My wife is going off on a business trip to Chicago for 4 days. I have to be without her for 3 nights. I have not slept without my wife. I have not gone to sleep without my wife. The 22 years that we have been together, twice we've spent the night apart, the 22 years we've been together. So this isn't fun for her and I. We don't like these business trips. We don't like when she has to be gone, and we don't get to sleep in the same bed together and fall asleep next to one another. That makes it hard for us to even get sleep. By the time she's done with this business trip, she's going to be exhausted simply because she won't sleep good, and she's traveling, and I'm going to be exhausted simply because I won't sleep well either. So, but it's business, and it has to be done, and you know, we'll get through it. We just won't like it. I definitely won't. So if I don't seem like myself in the daily vlogs, especially Monday, the first day she leaves, or Tuesday, because Monday she don't leave until around 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So Tuesday I'm probably going to be a little out of sorts, because honestly she is my strength, and really what gets me through each day, having her by my side. And when she's not by my side, it's a bit of a bad situation. I mean, I'll be fine, and I'll get through it. I worry about her being gone. I worry about her being in Chicago, and I worry about her even traveling there. All the more as they're there. Once she gets there and she's safe in her hotel, then I feel a little bit better. And her whole business meeting convention thing is right in the hotel she's in, I'm pretty sure, so she don't have to do any traveling around Chicago. She gets to her hotel and then she's there for the 3 nights, 4 days, and then she travels home, which makes me nervous as well. But I will be doing a load of praying to make sure she has a very safe trip. And if you're the type who prays, feel free. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this episode of the weekend vlog, and I will do my best to edit it and make it somewhat interesting. Like I said, I lost track of a lot of things going on this weekend because it was a super extremely busy weekend for me. But I will see you in tomorrow's video. Thanks for watching. Bye!